Hi, so far we've solved systems of equations by graphing two lines and seeing where they intersect. Then we solved systems by substitution, and now we're going to solve systems of linear equations by elimination or addition subtraction method. So write your name, write what period you're in, circle what the date is, if it's the third or the fourth. Solve each system by elimination. Show all work. It's math, so you're always going to show all work. So we're going to focus in on the first problem. We're trying to eliminate one of the variables. So if we add the two equations together, what's x plus negative x? Zero. What's negative 3 plus y plus negative 10y? Negative 13y equals negative 3 plus 16 is 13. Divide by negative 13. We get y equals negative 1. But we want x and y. We want them both. So you pick an equation to substitute this back in. So if we pick the top equation, x minus 3y, y is negative 1, equals negative 3. X plus 3 equals negative 3. Subtract 3 from both sides. X equals negative 6. So then we write the answer as an ordered pair, just like we've been doing for all the problems. So what's the order of our coordinates? Negative 6, negative 1, x comma y. So that was an easy one because all we had to do was add the two equations and the x's got eliminated. On number 2, it's much the same. Which variable will be eliminated if we just add the two equations together? The y's, right? So we get x equals negative x equals negative 6 because you have 4x minus 5y. When you add them together, you get negative x equals y. Negative 6, so x equals 6. If the opposite of x is negative 6, then x is 6. Multiply both sides by negative 1. So x is 6. And then pick an equation up here to substitute in 6 for x. 4 times 6 is 24 plus 7y equals negative 4. We need to move the 24 to the other side by subtracting. 7y equals negative 28. They're both negative, so we add them and put the negative sign. Divide by 7. Make it y equals negative 4. So then you write the answer as an ordered pair. So what is the answer? 6, negative 4, x comma y. So those are the simplest kind where you just add the two equations in the form that they already are. On number 3, we're going to have to do some multiplication. We want to get the same coefficient for the x's or for the y's. So let's try to get a 2 for the x, and because there's a 2 here. And let's try to get a negative 2, because then when we add them together, they will cancel out. So we're going to get opposite coefficients. So I'm going to multiply everything by negative 2. So this stays the same, but we write it again carefully. And then we multiply by negative 2. Negative 2x plus 14y equals negative 36. Then we add them together. 2x minus 2y is 0. It's eliminated. 20y equals negative 60. divide by 20. Y equals negative 3. And then you have to go back to an equation. This one is simpler, the bottom one. So we do x minus 7 times negative 3. Substituting negative 3 equals 18. X plus 21 equals 18. Subtract 21. X equals negative 3. So order pair is negative 3, negative 3. And that's all you do for number 3. So you have to multiply one of the equations by a number so that it will eliminate one of the variables, that they have the same ordered pair but or same coefficient but opposite. So if we look at number 4, if we multiply this by negative 2, we have negative 6x minus 6y equals negative 6. Multiply this by negative 2, we get 6x plus 6y equals 6. And when we add, see how the x's get eliminated? Oh, and the y's also get eliminated. And this is also eliminated. Negative 6 plus 6 is 0. Is 0 equal to 0? Always true. So what do we write when something is always true? How many solutions are there? There are infinitely many solutions. This is the same line twice. This is just two times this one. This one times 2 is this one. It's the same line, so they intersect everywhere. Infinitely many solutions. The next problem, we can't eliminate any of the variables by adding. We can't multiply one equation by something to cancel out, so we have to multiply both equations by something. So we have to decide if we want to eliminate the x's or the y's. So if we eliminate the x's, we're going to have to multiply this by 5 and this by 8. So it'll be 40 and 40. So over here, we're going to get 40x plus 35y equals 40. Negative 40x, so they will cancel. Plus 24y equals 48. This is 88. And this is 959y. Is that right? It's negative 24. 8 times negative 3 is negative 24. So 35 minus 24 is 11y. So then we divide by 11 and we get y equals 8. So this is the hardest kind. We have to multiply both equations by a number so that they will eliminate one of the variables. And then we're going to pick one of the equations to substitute in to find x. So 8 is y, so I picked the top equation. 8x plus 56 equals 8. 8x equals negative 48. Divide by 8. X equals negative 6. So our ordered pair is negative 6, 8. Negative 6, 8. So the rest are the same type of problems. So there's three levels. One where you just add them right away. One where you multiply one equation by something in order to eliminate one of the variables. And one where you have to multiply both equations by something. So if we look here, If you multiply the top equation by 3 and the bottom equation by 2, they would both be 18 and negative 18. That would be small. I can multiply the bottom equation by negative 5 and the top equation by 4, and we'd have 20 and 20. Let's do this one. This by 3 and this by 2. So we get negative 18x minus 15y equals negative 60. 18x minus 8y equals negative 32. The x's cancel. We get negative 23y equals negative 92 divided by negative 23 divided by negative 23. You might have to do some division. We get y equals 4. 4 times 3 is 12. Carry the 1. 4 times 2 is 8 plus 1 is 9. So it does come out to be 4. And then you pick one of the equations to substitute it back in. So the 4 will be our y coordinate. We need to find x. So let's do negative 6x minus 5 times 4 equals negative 20. Negative 6x minus 20 equals negative 20. Negative 6x, add 20 to both sides. So it makes it a 0. Divide by negative 6. X equals 0 over anything is 0. 0 divided by anything is 0. The 0 can be on the numerator, just not on the denominator. Let's try one more before you're ready for homework number 10. We have a 6 and a 4. They both go into 12. That's better than multiplying this by 7 and this by 8. Then you'd have really big numbers. So if we multiply this by 3 and this by 2, let's see what happens. 12x minus 24y equals negative 48. Negative 12x, so those are going to cancel, plus 14y equals 28. Negative 24 plus 14 is negative 10y equals negative 20. Divide by negative 10, y equals 2. And then pick an equation to substitute it in. 4x minus 8 times 2 equals negative 16. 4x minus 16 equals negative 16. Add 16 to both sides. 4x equals 0. Divide by 4. X equals 0. 0, 2. And you can try number 8 if you want to. The answer is no solution. I wish we had gotten to it. The answer is no solution because you get two things that are not really equal to each other. That's never true. So if you get two things that are equal to each other, then it's infinitely many solutions. If you get two things that are not equal to each other, then you get no solution. Okay? And I'll make sure on the homework that there's a no solution so you get more practice. Good luck.